Hi students, welcome to online class. The last class we are discussed about pollination by wind and pollination by water. Okay, two agents we have discussed. Today we are going to discussing another two agents of pollination, that is biotic factors, living factors, that is pollination by insect and pollination by animals. I hope the last topics you understood. The pollination by wind and pollination by water. Yes, okay. So today we are going to discussing these two topics, the pollination by insect and pollination by animals. Okay, the first one is pollination by insect. Did you observe if any time in your garden the butterflies and the bees and some other insects also visit the flowers? Why they are visiting the flower? Simply they are just going to visit the flower? No. They are collecting the nectar. So at the same time, when they collect the nectar, the pollen grains also stick in their body. It helps the pollination. Only the bees and the insects. Okay, insects, these visit only one flower? No, they visit most all the flowers. Okay, so at the same time, they are just drop down the word pollen grains to another plant flower. Stigmas, okay, like this way the pollination occur in case of insect. So let us see, pollination by insect is also known as entomophily. Okay, so when the when they are pollinated by insect, this pollination is known as entomophilous type of cross pollination. So in this type of pollination, insects are helps to transfer pollen grains from one flower to another plant flower. This is the most common method of pollination. Okay, clear? So what are the characteristic features of insect pollinated flowers? If you have any idea? Yes, it is bright color flower and it is showy flower, which means large flower. So most of the flowers are bright colored and bright colored petal. For what they have the bright color petal? Because it attracts the insect. Yes. Give an example of this bright color flower. Yes, rose, then hibiscus, then marigold. Yes, more flowers are there. So which one is the bright color flower and large flower? These are the examples of pollinated by insect. Okay, and second character, most of the insect pollinated flowers are producing what? Nectar. That's why the insect visit the flower. Okay, and most of the insect pollinated flowers have sweet smell. Smell of rose, it's sweet smell. Yes, and jasmine. Yes, mostly all the insect pollinated flower that is sweet smell and it is producing nectar and it is bright colored petal. It attract the insects. And the pollen grains are, most of these flowers are sticky type. Why they are sticky type? Then only when the insects insect visit the flower, it will stick on their body. Okay, so these are the characteristics of pollinated by pollination by insect flowers. Okay, clear? Yes. Next we are going to discussing that pollination by animals. Okay, pollination by animals. Do you know that some birds, they are just suck the nectar from the flower? So this pollination is also called as zoophily. Okay, when the pollination is carried out with the help of animals, it is known as zoophilous type of cross pollination. The plants which carry out zoophilous type of pollination have flowers with hairy pollen or pollen grains, so they can stick to the body of animals. When these animals comes in contact with the flower of another plant, they deliver the pollen to its stigma. Like this way they achieve the pollination. Okay, so I hope all of you understood this topic. Yes, thank you.